kids motivated to read the text. And I'm hoping that the activities that we do today will give you ideas on how to motivate your readers back to school. Well, what I'm going to ask you to do is we have a simple annotation key. There's more annotation samples. You can do whatever you want as a teacher for your annotation key. What I'd like you to do is, as you're reading, you're going to underline the central main or key ideas, your ideas. Again, don't take the Denise O'Brien method and highlight the whole article. Right? You've got to have narrowed down your choices. Circle any confusing or unclear phrases or words or things that you are just thinking in your head, I don't know if my kids would do this. I don't know how I would do this in my classroom, those kind of pieces. In your notes, you're going to write just notes to yourself or questions. Later today, you're going to experience what's called a Socratic seminar, which again is one of the most powerful strategies. I wish I had my tool belt when I was in the classroom because my discussions would have been that much richer. But we need to have questions going into there. So questions might be, I'm a music teacher. How are other music teachers in their school district using, would use annotation or use close reading in their classroom? So I have that when I go talk to my music teacher friends, because you're going to have that opportunity. What do I want to ask them about it in the music classroom? Maybe in my art classroom, how would I use this part of the text doesn't make sense to me, especially as an art teacher, math teacher, how would we use this in math? So creating questions based on your school currently as it is, how you might use it, or in your content area that you can use later on when you're with your content area folks. Does that make sense? So just generating some questions. And then when you are done reading, you're going to go back. So you've already read it all, you're going to go back and you're going to start the most important idea in your mind that you would think you would want to.